Hello everyone, I'm Fabiola, free episode, and today I'm here to talk about Ayurveda. Ayurveda is the sister science of yoga, and Ayurveda is mean science of life. Ayurveda is a manual of to live a healthy and feel and full life. And is medicine through food, and is based on the theory of the five elements that are earth, water, fire, air, and space, ether. Basically, the combination of these five elements create the dosha. We have three dosha that are Pitta, Vata, and Kapha. Basically, Pitta is the combination of the fire element and the water element. Vata is the combination of air and space. And Kapha is earth and water. Everyone in their body has all these five elements, all these three dosha, but the predominance of one of these elements can cause a dysfunction, or we need to know our dosha to understand better also how to balance when it's not in balance. Basically, we have three prototype of person that has the more or less the same quality. Basically, a person that is Vata is very skinny. He has like a very tiny hair. Is also a person that is very enthusiastic, is creative, and when this dosha is in balance, is very creativity, is always in the future, is movement, has the quality of the air and the space. We have Pitta that is water and fire, and the quality are like they are very tall, they are very definite muscle. They are strong, and they are very productive. They are leader for nature. And yeah, they have like this fire element very, very strong in themselves. And we have Kapha that they are like maybe a little bit more robust. They are very compassion. They are very friendly. They love to hear people, and they have like this motherhood lifestyle, motherhood approach to people, to life. So this is when these three dosha are in balance. If you recognize yourself in one of these characteristic, maybe is your dosha, but it's always better to have like a proper test, because we also need to know our prakriti, that is the characteristic that we have when we are born. So it's a combination between the characteristic that we have in our physical body, but also in our mind, and also our lifestyle can influence our dosha. Anyway, when the dosha is not in balance, for example, for a Vata person, he starts like to be very anxious, very agitated, very stressful. He can suffer of insomnia. He cannot sleep. So these are the imbalance of the Vata dosha. For Pitta, they are very irascible, they are very angry, they are like greed, possessive. So when we have a disbalance in Pitta, we have this quality. And for Kapha, they are like more lethargic, they don't want to do things, they are very static. As also their element is the earth, that is the stability, but sometimes they are very stuck in what they are doing. So why is important to know and recognize these unbalanced because we can also balance the things with the opposite. So Ayurveda is a basic of the principle of the opposite, where like increase like, and the opposite can balance the things. So for example, if you are a Vata constitution, so you are very skinny, you are very dry, and you start to suffer on one of these imbalances. For example, you have like a very dry skin, or you are too skinny. What do you have to do? For example, we can balance with the lifestyle, but also with the aliment, with the food. So let's take an example, the salad. If you think about the salad, is a with a lot of space in the salad, so it's not adapted when you have an imbalance in Vata. So what you have to do, maybe have food that are more with more earth element, that are more oily, to balance this dryness. Or for example, also if you are like very confused, very like in your head, maybe it's time to slow down, to go in nature, to have this reconnection with your root. So it's important, yeah, to know this difference. If for example you are a kapha and you start like to be like very lethargic, very slow, very sometimes depressed, they also suffer of overweight. So, for example, for them, a salad is fine because it's full of air that they miss in their constitution, or they can do movement. Movement is amazing for a Kapha constitution because they need some motivation, they need movement, they need to go. So, for example, asanas, go to run, they need maybe someone that is a Vata that give them like more vitality. And if you have a Pitta constitution, that can, you can also have like some skin problem, some you are like overheating about your body, so you have like to balance with the cool qualities. So for example, eat something that is more fresh, more fresh fruit. Also go for meditation is fine. So find a way to re recognize the quality of your element when they are unbalanced and how to balance them. And yeah, it's important because everyone has his own constitution, everyone is unique. So as much we know our true nature, and as much we can balance and live in a life that is in harmony. And also, well, we have to think that every hours of the day has like a different energy. But of this, maybe we talk in another videos. But decide the moment of the day that you know that some energy is more strong to balance in the opposite way. For today is all. I hope that this video can be useful for someone. And yeah, I want also yeah to say a little small things to wind it up. That also that is very important to know Ayurveda also because Ayurveda is a way to live a healthy life and to prevent disease, because the majority of the disease that we have is also for a question of lifestyle, a question of mental health. So as much as we know our constitution and we can recognize a problem before to aggravate it, the best is it, and the more we can prevent illness, and the best is it. So I really recommend you to have a consultation of Ayurveda and recognize your dosha and go deeply in this study. For now is everything, and I hope to see you soon. Namaste.